In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to include images in your page, and we'll be looking at two different cases. We'll look at the case where the image is in the same folder as your HTML files, and we'll look at the case where the image is in a different folder, in a subfolder. So, I'm assuming you've downloaded the source code files of this module, and if you have done so, go to the folder that's called images, that has the assets for the images lesson. And you'll see that inside of the project, there's an image called background.png. So this we'll use this one for the case where the image file is in the same folder as the index file. There's also a folder called images, and inside that there's another image. It's really the same image, but it has a different name and it's located in a different place so that you can learn how to link, how to include those images as well. So let's get started. The tag that we use for images is called the img tag. So I'm going to add an image here, and I'm going to start by opening up my img tag. So you need to include an attribute called source and indicate the location of the image. If the image is located in a different URL, you have to add the full URL, such as this, like the full location of the image, including HTTP, the domain, wherever the image is located. That's if it's located in an external place. But if it's included in the same folder as your index.html, you can simply type in the name of your image with the extension, of course. Same as we did with links. So everything I'm doing here is the same for links. And one way to do this is by closing the image tag in this way. Now, as you can see, this is a sandwich without filling, and this for some reason feels wrong. There is something in HTML called self-closing tags, and you use that whenever you don't have this, when you don't have this situation, when you don't, for tags that don't have an inside filling, you just close them like this. This is called a self-closing tag. And the best way to think of them is by thinking of a donut, which is in some way a self-closing sandwich with no real filling. It can have attributes as well, but it doesn't have an actual filling. And the tag that we're showing here, the break tag, is a tag that you can use to add new lines inside of a paragraph. So for example, I've got this paragraph here, and I can add a break tag like that, like so, and that will skip a line, but we're still inside of this paragraph. So if we look at that, the browser, you'll see that it basically jumps a new line. And you can add multiple lines. This is a way you can use to add more lines in your text paragraphs. But don't use it to actually position your elements, because that's done with CSS. So continuing with images. This is how we can include an image that's located in the same folder. If you want to include an image that's located in a subfolder, so we've got the folder images and then another image in here, you have to type in the name of that other folder, then /, and the name of that file, which is another image.png. So this will show that other image that we wanted to include. To summarize, the img tag is what we use to include images. The source or src attribute allows you to specify the location of this image. If the image is an external page and you know the full URL, you can include it like so. It needs to have obviously the image file name at the end. If you have that, you can add it in this way. If the image is in the same folder as your page, you can just include the name. And if it's in a subfolder or many subfolders, you can add all the folders like that, use /, until you find the file, and then you specify the full name of the file. Lastly, some tags, and the image is one of them, that don't have a filling can be presented as self-closing tags, for which the best way to look at is the donut analogy. So now have a play with this code, go buy a donut if you're hungry, and let's continue.